Did you know that 30 minutes of stress are enough to change some features of your brain from the male form to the female form, or from the female form to the male form? I didn't know that either, but when I realized this, it completely transformed how I was thinking about sex, gender, and the brain. Many people believe that men and women are fundamentally different, men from Mars and women from Venus, and that the reason that they are so different is that men have male brains and women have female brains. A very popular theory claims that already in the womb, testosterone changes the form of the default female brain into a male form. So male babies are born with a male brain and female babies are born with a female brain. Now this is quite true when you think about testosterone effects on the genitalia. Already in the womb, testosterone in males transform the form of the different genital organs to the female, to the male form. So indeed, baby boys are born with male genitalia and baby girls are born with female genitalia. But the study I cited in the beginning suggests that something different is happening in the brain. So let's look at this study together. In this study, the researchers look at the density of dendritic spines. These are the small little red dots that are located along the green dendrites. And here you can see a piece of dendrite from a male and a piece of dendrite from a female. And you can easily see the difference. Males have few spines, females have lots of spines. But remember, there was another group of rats in this study, and they underwent 30 minutes of stress one day before their brains were tested. And again, we see a sex difference, but it is reversed. What we thought was typical of males, few spines, we now see in the stressed female. What we thought was typical of females, lots of spines, we now see in the stressed male. This type of reversal of sex effects are very common in the brain. And when you look at all these studies that find that how sex affects brain features can be opposite under different conditions, you realize that these different manipulations do not flip the entire brain from the male form to the female form or from the female form to the male form. Rather, they affect only some brain features. So even if I assume that right now my entire brain is in the female typical form, then following such an event, some of my brain features will change their form, other will not, and I will have a mosaic brain, a brain of both male typical and female typical features. And indeed, a study we've conducted in my lab have shown that in most humans, their brain is mosaic, each a unique mosaic of female typical and male typical brain features. So if brains do not come in two forms, male and female, how about humans? Are there men and women? There are differences between men and women in cognitive abilities, in personality characteristics, in behaviors, in preferences. I'm not going to discuss at all the question of where do these differences come from, nature or nurture. The only question I'm interested in is whether these differences add up consistently within each of us to create male nature and female nature. And our studies have found, what I'm sure you already know, that each one of us is composed of a unique mosaic of gender characteristics, of feminine and masculine characteristics. So when you meet someone, typically they will have either male or female genitalia. But you hardly never meet someone with a male or a female brain, or with only masculine or only feminine characteristics. We always meet people who have a gender mosaic, a composition unique to each person of their gender and brain characteristics. So I suggest we get rid of the gender binary, the system that assigns meaning to people according to the form of genitalia, that assigns roles and expectations to people to adults and children according to the form of the genitalia, and we start treating ourselves and others according to the unique mosaic that each one of us is. Thank you very much.